What's going on, everybody? My name is Alex Freeberg, and today we're going to be talking about aliasing. Now, all aliasing really is temporarily changing the column name or the table name in your script, and it's not really going to impact your output at all. Aliasing is really used for the readability of your script so that if you hand this off to somebody or somebody comes behind you and starts working on this, they can more easily understand it. And it may not sound super useful, especially for small scripts like what we have on the screen. But when you start getting to larger scripts where you have 6, 7, or 8 joins and you're selecting 10 different column names, it actually is very useful and very important. So let's get into how that actually works, and then I'll have an example later of how we can use aliasing with a little bit of a larger query. So in this table, let's select first name and execute. What we want to do is just write as, and let's do fname. And all that's going to do is it's going to rename this column from first name, which it was originally named, to fname. Now, you can use as, but you can also just get rid of that and do it exactly how I have it, and it's still going to work perfectly. You can either use the as or you can not use it. I typically don't, and I just put a space in between the actual column and the alias. Let's look at an example of how this might actually be useful. So we have a first name and a last name in this column, so what we're going to do is actually combine those. So let's do plus, and let's add a space in there, and let's do a plus, and let's do last name. So this is gonna take the first name, add a space, and then do the last name, and we're gonna do that as, and let's do full name. And let's execute this. So now we have a column called full name, which is our alias. So we've combined the first name and the last name column into one single column, and we've renamed it full name. If we had not used this alias at all, it would have just said this, which is no column name at all. We don't typically want that when we have an output. We want to give this column a name so that somebody who's actually looking at the script or who's looking at the output of the script actually understands what is contained within this column. So for that, we're just going to keep it as full name. Now, another time that you're often going to use aliasing in the select statement is when you're using aggregate functions. So in this table, we have age. So let's pull that up really quick. So we have age right here, and let's actually just do the average age. And when we execute this, we're gonna get no column name and 31. So what we want to do is give it average age. And when we do that, we now have a column name. And again, you want to have a column name in case someone comes up behind you and is reading the script so that they understand what this column is being used for. Now that we've looked at aliasing column names, let's look at aliasing table names. It basically is the exact same thing. We're just gonna write as, and let's do demo for demographics. And let's do demo dot, and it's gonna give us all of our options, and we'll do employee ID. So when you alias in a table name, when you are selecting in the select statement, you actually need to preface your column name with a table name or the table alias dot, and then employee ID. And this is extremely important to do, especially when you have a lot of joins that you're doing, or you're selecting a lot of columns when you have several joins, because it can get very, very messy quick. So let's actually join this to employee salary. And let's do that on demo.employee ID is equal to sal. Dot employee ID. So now let's do demo dot employee ID comma sal dot, and let's do salary. So looking at the script now, it is very clean, it is very easy to understand, and that is what's so important with aliasing. If, for example, we took this off, every time we wanted to reference this table, we would have to put the entire table name. And putting the entire table name is correct, it just is very cumbersome and does not look clean at all. And so using something like demo as an alias makes it a lot more easily readable and a lot more manageable when you're looking at it when you have a very long script. Let's look at this query where we're joining together 3 separate tables. And after each table, we have an alias. For employee demographics, we have A. Employee salary, we have B. And warehouse employee demographics, we have C. Now, unfortunately, I have seen a lot of scripts that look exactly like this, and this is what you do not want to do. You do not want to use your aliasing to just write an A, a B, or a C. That is very frowned upon when writing queries because it really doesn't give any context to what the table that you're referencing is, and it gets really confusing as this query continues to grow And as you add more columns to your select statement, it makes it more difficult to understand where those columns are coming from. And so when I'm reading that, I say select A.EmployeeID. Okay, what's A? A is employee demographics. So you really do not want to do that. Now let's look at an example of what it should look like. So for employee demographics, instead of having an alias of A, I used demo for demographics. For employee salary, I used sal, and for warehouse employee demographics, I used where. Now, this is not perfect by any means, but in the select statement, if you're just glancing at it, you can easily understand which columns are coming from which tables. So when I look at employee ID, I know that's coming from employee demographics because I have demo as the alias. So it's a lot easier to understand, and when you hand this query off to somebody, it is going to be a lot easier for them to read through it and understand where those columns and those table names are coming from. And so they will appreciate that in the long run. So that is all I got. That is aliasing. Again, not a super tough subject, but a really important one to understand, especially as you start working in teams and as you start creating more and more complex queries, you want to have it more organized and more easily readable. And so it may not come into play with those really simple queries, but again, as you build out those more complex queries, this becomes very useful. I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to comment and subscribe below. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.